In this video, you're going to learn how to create dashboards in Google Data Studio, including adding elements to your dashboard and customizing your data. I'll also cover the benefits of using Google Data Studio to visualize and present data from Google Analytics, as well as Google Sheets. I'm Benjamin, and I'm going to help you get the most out of your data to improve your website and online marketing. If you haven't already, then please subscribe to receive the latest tips, tutorials, and more. Let's get started. We'll jump into Google Data Studio in just a moment, but I just wanted to really highlight the key benefit of using Google Data Studio over, say, the standard reports or the dashboard options inside Google Analytics. And that's really that what we're doing is we're creating something that's very dynamic. So with the dashboarding options, we can add in things like a date range selector so that when people are actually engaging with the dashboard, they can manipulate the data they're finding in there in a live scenario. So let's now have a look at a couple of dashboards. So we're going to actually create these two dashboards today. First, we're going to create this audience overview dashboard, and I'm actually going to walk through the steps that I went through to create this dashboard. So it has some key pieces of information. So these are top level metrics along with trends for this particular website. We can see we've got some trending and some comparison, as well as some details about the pieces of content that people are engaging with on the actual website itself. And we can also see that date range selector, so actually making it dynamic inside Google Data Studio. So this is the first Data Studio report we'll look at creating. And the second Data Studio report we'll look at is this one. So this is actually combining data from some different Google Analytics reporting views. So it's actually combining four different sets of data to recreate a report inside Google Data Studio. Because this is one of the other key benefits of Data Studio, is that we're not just looking at one piece of data, we can actually supplement additional pieces of data in. So for example, in this case, I'm actually combining data from four different sets of Google Analytics views, but we can also do things like add in additional pieces of data, for example, from Google AdWords or from YouTube or anything that we can pull into Google Sheets as well. So this is a really key benefit for Data Studio. So let's jump in now to Data Studio and have a look at the interface. So here what we can see is the home section of Google Data Studio. And across the top, we can see there's some templates or some sample reports. You'll actually also find these down here inside the interface. So you'll actually jump in and you'll find that this is the same in all the different Google Data Studio accounts. You can also see up the top here, I've created a few dashboards myself. So these are my dashboards that I can also find inside Google Data Studio. And we can see here, we can flick between ones that I own or ones that are shared with me. And on top of that, we can also come down and see the different data sources. So I'll talk about this in a moment, but basically we can pull in some sample data, for example, from the Google Analytics demo account. But of course, we're going to be supplementing in our own data, so pulling in data from our own Google Analytics accounts, from our own Google Sheets, and so on. So from here, I'm going to click on Start a New Report. So this is going to kick things off, and we're starting from scratch inside Google Data Studio. So our first step is to select a particular data source. So we can actually use one of the sample ones. For today, I'm going to use the sample Google Analytics data from the Google Merchandise Store. But you also have the option, of course, to come down the bottom here and actually pull in your own data set from your own Google Analytics or Google Sheets and so on. So let's kick off. I'm going to click on Google Analytics data, and I'm going to add this to my report. And so now I can begin actually editing my report. So the first report I'm going to create is the audience overview report, and this is going to be in landscape. So I just need to modify this report. So I click on File, Report and Theme Settings. And then just on the right hand side here, I can click on Layout and I can just change this to Portrait. So it's a more classic style reporting template. So next up, I need to add my elements into my Google Data Studio report. So I can see across the top here, I have a range of options, pie charts, trend lines, and so on. You'll also find these on the insert dropdown as well. So it's up to you, use whatever you're more comfortable with. So for me, I'm going to start off with a scorecard. This is basically a straight metric, so I can just drag and drop, and this will now add this element into my canvas. So here we can see I have the number of sessions, and this is pulled directly from the data source I selected, which was the Google Analytics sample data. So I can now change the particular metric I see. So I'm going to click on sessions, which is the default, and then we can see all the different metrics that are available here. So I can pull in data from AdWords or goal conversion data from Google Analytics, all these sorts of things. The search option is super helpful. You'll find that this helps speed up your creation of dashboards. So I'm just going to click on the search option. And for me, I want users. So I come down and select users, and this will update the scorecard or the metric inside the canvas here. Some other things I can do, so I can just click back. And one thing that can be super helpful is having a date comparison. So we can actually do a comparison of the metric we're seeing here, so 61,000 odd users in this example, to the previous period. So that would be the 28 days prior to the date range we're looking at. Or ideally, this is the one we'd want to go with, is previous year, so the same date range from the previous year. So I can select on this, and we can see now it's going to update. And we can actually see that we have that comparison. So year on year, we're actually up 32% in terms of our user figures from Google Analytics. I also like to add the detail back in there just for context. So you can click on style, and I just like to deselect hide. So this tells us straight away inside the interface that we are looking at a comparison to the previous year. So that's our first element we've added into our dashboard, and we can move that around on the grid as well. So another nice thing is we can copy and paste. So you can just do this on your keyboard, or you can also go through copy and paste, and this will paste that element back in. So now we can actually use this to create additional scorecards. So in my case, in my audience overview scorecard, I want to add in page views, bounce rate, and some other engagement metrics. So I can just go ahead now and actually modify the data. So I can just come back through, follow the same steps to find the pieces of data I'd like to add in to my Google Data Studio dashboard. Now that I have all the elements I want, I can move them around. I can just drag and select the elements and just make sure they're aligning in the way I want. And now I can go ahead and add some additional elements to my dashboard. So I'm going to add a pie chart with details about the different channels that people are using to find my website. So now I can come in. Again, it's loading the sample data up. I'm going to change the dimension in this case to default channel groupings. Since there's a lot of data here, I'm going to go back and I'm going to adjust some things here. So I can actually come back, click on style, and I'm going to reduce the number of slices down to 6, so the top 6 channel groupings. And you can also make this a donut chart, so I can just pull that to the position. And now I'm going to go ahead and add in a bar chart. This time I'm going to use the bar chart to show the different devices people are using. So again, select where I want to put it. I can come back, select my data. So I'm going to use the device category for this one. And now I can adjust this bar chart. So I can come back in, I can say I want horizontal, and I can also just remove the elements, and I can just make it a little bit bigger. And so now I can see the different devices people are using to find and interact with the website. So next up, I'm going to create a trend line. So I'm going to come up and I'm going to use the time series option, and I can drag that across. And now I'm going to look at users. So I'm just going to modify this to users. And I can also come back in and do a few things. So I can actually do a comparison to the previous year right within the trend line. And I might even just make a slight cosmetic change. I'm going to add in the points for each spot on the chart. And finally, for the data I'm including in this dashboard, I'm going to include some details about the pages people are engaging with. So I'm going to include a table. So now I can add in the details. I can come into data. For me, I'm going to include pages or the page. So now I can see the different pages people are engaging with. I can come back in and I can add in additional metrics. So in this particular case, I'm going to switch sessions to page views instead. And I'm also going to add in another metric, which is bounce rate, so an engagement metric. So now I can see this inside the report. The other thing to note, and you'll see this when we jump into the live example, is you can still tab through the different results here. So we're just looking at the top 10, but you can certainly travel through and view the other ones. Now there's some other things that we can do with the report. So we can actually do things like this. So we can actually come into the columns, and I might want some visual detail about the page views in this particular instance. So I can click on bar, and this is going to mean that I can see a quick bar chart, and I can also choose to include the number. So now I can see not only the number of page views, but I have this visual reference to understand the how that sort of adds up in the scheme of all the different pages people are engaging with. The other thing that you may have already noticed is the heat map option. So here, for example, with bounce rate, I can quickly highlight pages that have a higher bounce rate. So you can use the heat map option to quickly highlight those particular metrics that have a higher value in this particular case. So now I have the basics down for all the metrics and dimensions that I want inside my dashboard. So I can see they're all here. And from here, my next step is really to just clean this up in terms of the design. So I'm going to add in a header and just some other elements to make sure that it's nice and clean and crisp for the people I'm delivering it to. So I can go ahead and I can do this. So for example, I can add in a bit of a header. So I can just drag a rectangle in. So I can add this in. I can change the color. And then I might sort of move my different elements around. So just clean them up a bit. And I can also add in additional text to give my report a heading. On top of this, I can also add in a date range tool. So this will basically make the report more interactive. It will mean that people can actually come in and manipulate the date range they're looking at for my dashboard. So here I can actually click on data and I can select the default. So I might say my default is, say, the last 30 days of data and click on apply. So now what will happen is people can actually come in and modify the data that's available inside this rolling report. If you want to have a look, just click on the edit toggle. So this now gives us our live report so we can see our dashboard, and you can see that it is interactive. You can actually tab through the different pieces of information we've included in the dashboard. And importantly, I also have this option now to manipulate the date range I'm looking at. So I can enter in a start and an ending date, and now the report will actually refresh for me. And I can come back in and edit the report again. And I can come back in and continue to tweak it until I'm happy with my dashboard report. And now I'm happy with my final dashboard report inside Google Data Studio. Now we're going to look at how we can actually combine different sets of data. In my example, I'm going to combine different pieces of Google Analytics data to create a report across four different websites that I've done here. So we can actually see we've got the overall trend at the top, and then coming down, I can actually hover over and see the performance broken down by the different site. So to do this, I'm going to need to use Google Sheets to actually aggregate this data together for me to combine it into Google Data Studio. So let's jump into Google Sheets. So here in Google Sheets, what we're doing is I'm actually using the Google Analytics add-on to actually pull in data from, in this case, four different websites from Google Analytics. And I'm just pulling some basic details. So I'm just pulling the session numbers across these four different sites. So what we can see here is we're pulling this data and I can see I've got my number of sessions and it's now going to, in the final sheet here, actually combine them all up. So now I've got the number of sessions for each of my sites and then the total number of combined sessions. And we're going to be pulling this data into Google Data Studio now. So let's head back into Data Studio. Here I can create my new report. So I'll just click on Start a New Report. And now I need to pull in my data from Google Sheets. So I'm going to click on Create New Data Source. And you can see here all the different options we have available for pulling data into Data Studio. Lots of Google products, of course, from analytics we've looked at through to AdWords. And for me, I'm going to use Google Sheets because this gives me huge flexibility in the data that I can pull in. So from here, I can see the sheets I have access to. I'm going to click on the one that I want, which is Combined Data Example, and I'm going to use my combined worksheet out of that particular spreadsheet. So now I can click on Connect. And now I have the different details that I'm pulling in, and I'm just going to click on Add to Report. So now for my example, I'm just going to keep it simple today. I'm going to create a time series with my combined data for all those four different websites being measured into Google Analytics. And straight away, I now have that data available right within my Data Studio report. So this gives me now my total trend for all four sites combined. So absolutely great way to actually combine different data into a report using Google Data Studio. So from here I can tweak things, of course. I might want to make some slight sort of tweaks. You can also, of course, add in things like a trend line if you choose. So I can add that in. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in this additional element around actually splitting it apart, so I can actually quickly hover over and see for that particular day, you know, how much traffic came from website 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So now I'm going to add in a new element into my report. So for this, I'm going to use a bar chart and I'm just going to pull it in. So I can see here I can pull in additional metrics. I'm going to combine these up here. So I'm just going to add them all in. Now I have my four metrics and I'm going to stack this chart. So now I can see the makeup for each date and I can actually come in. And now I can see I have my data coming in as I want. So it's a great example of actually combining different pieces of data into Google Data Studio, and you can see here Google Sheets is a great way to pull in custom data. So that's how you can use Google Data Studio. Tell me how you're using Google Data Studio. Let me know and leave your tips in the comments below. If you thought this video was helpful, please subscribe, share it with your friends, and hit the like button so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.